please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome back. We are just about a few seconds away from the pre-opening. Devin, quickly, Bajaj Auto after the fall?
Interesting, very interesting. I think Bajaj Auto is probably doing what Jio has done in the telecommunications segment. Bajaj Auto is doing in the two-wheeler segment. So certainly, I think they are leveraging their cash balance sheet very, very smartly. And they are trying to corner the market share of some of the entry-level model, market share of some of the entry-level models, both in the entry-level segment and the commuter segments. Mm. And at the same time, riding on the premium range of vehicles where they earn margins also, along with the exports. So I think Bajaj plays very smart. And I think that they should be winner in this entire game, if the war which is going on right now in the two-wheeler segment.
Okay. Just coming back to you with more questions, Devin, the markets have opened. Infosys can't be 10% down just because of a Facebook disappointment. I think things will correct. We shouldn't even be reading these numbers. L&T is starting with a 9% uptick. Mm-hmm. That also is bound to soften. Dr. Reddy's results today, it's up about 3%. iShares starting higher. But let's wait and see how these things pan out. Do we have a quote for Canada? Yes, we do. It's 10% higher. I don't think it'll start that much. But Canada on balance indicated that probably some of the PSU banks will actually be able to see better and better growth, and that growth will give them money to do the provisioning, the heavy lifting on provisioning. Canada is continuing to maintain that 8 to 9% uptick. In fact, Bank of India, Bank of Baroda, all of them could be influenced by this number. Yes Bank numbers today, 1% higher on that stock. PC Jewelers sees a further cut, and that's because they've asked Indra, I think, to withdraw their rating. Perhaps that's what's keeping that stock a little worried. Now, we'll do one thing. Allow the shares to settle down a bit. And in the meanwhile, get... I was only waiting for the rupee rate to come in. I think it's 68.71, so uninspiring opening. The dollar is cheaper by 7 pies. That's not saying much. So let's get to Manisha Gupta and take in all the action from the commodity space. Good morning, Manisha.
Morning, Lata. Thank you so much for that. Well, the action really seems to be back in case of the crude oil prices, where you have seen a third straight day of gains come in. Of course, a bit of a decline in the US dollar index does help. But on its own, the crude has a lot of fundamentals which seem to be working for it. One, of course, is that you have seen Saudi Arabia suspend its crude shipments through Red Sea shipping lane. This has happened after the Yemen rebels have continued to actually target the Saudi Arabia facilities. And that is what has led to this step there. Markets are anticipating that you might see some supply concerns arising because of that. The real assessment is still trickling in, but it has definitely led to some buying come back into the markets here. On the other side, you also have seen the U.S. inventories decline to the lowest in 3.5 years, and that also has added some premium to prices. We have seen prices decline by nearly 6% in the previous month. The markets have seen it as oversold, and there is some speculative buying as well coming back in case of the crude oil prices. The other area that seems to be holding well, really, is the base metal space. Because of the weakness in US dollar, the steel prices have continued to hold around 10-month highs, and we have seen that trickling effect come in on the other metals like nickel and zinc as well.
Okay, Manisha, thanks a lot for that. Well, a couple of stocks do deserve mention. Hero MotoCorp in pre-opening is down almost about 2.5% post those weak numbers. And on the upside, L&T is still standing tall. It's a 5.5% gain that L&T is seeing this morning in pre-opening. Let's see how that plays out. The other stock to look at is Jubilant FoodWorks. Credit Suisse has raised their target price on Jubilant FoodWorks to 1750 now versus 1575 earlier. They say that the business cycle is very strong. And of course, Canara Bank continues to be a big mover. Maruti, ahead of its numbers, is also up almost about 1-odd%. Our guests are still with us. Sudarshan, L&T from a trading angle and also from a long-term standpoint, does it still deserve a buy at this 1400 level?
Well, from a trading angle, I wouldn't buy it. It's opening, suggesting a gap up, and good for it, but there is nothing to suggest that it will outperform. And for a long-term investor, it's infrastructure, so you should be having it in your portfolio, but it may continue to underperform.
Okay, your all-time favorite public sector banks are actually in the green now, Sudarshan. Canara Bank in particular, of course, up about 4% now. It's not 10%, 4%. But they've all been charging up a bit Is there a trading play, a positional play, Sudarshan, in any of the PSU banks? And I'm including State Bank.
Lata, much to my surprise, Canara Bank is actually a buying opportunity. I was going to give it today.
Okay.
Then I thought, okay, let me not. Most PSU banks
so
are.
So you still can. You still
but
can.
The better banks. Yes, Canara Bank is a buying opportunity. Actually, you can buy it and hold it. It's a positional trade, not just a short-term trade.
Fair point. Okay, let me then address that to Deven as well. Deven, the Canara Bank numbers definitely indicated a healing process. They have lent more loans. The amount of loans that have slipped into the red are declining rather sharply. It's higher than average. But, you know, last quarter, it was 13,000 crores. This time, it's 4,000 crores. So, what's the call?
Well, I don't know about Canara Bank, but in general, PSU banks, particularly, I think, starting with SBI, you should be seeing relatively a breather or a reprieve in the quarterly results also now. The provisioning is coming down for sure, and at the same time, the recovery of money is getting reflected in the books, particularly in the books of SBI. I think you should be seeing a reflection of the money that they have been recovering through NCLT processes. So I think from that point of view, if you look at the PSBs, maybe I would not say good time starting, but at the same time, I think the tough times are getting over for these banks. How much they would be in a position to lend in a successive quarters, I think that would be something interesting to watch out for. But as of now, I believe that the worst seems to be over for PSBs, and probably we should be seeing relatively better times ahead. Whether we should buy these stocks, I think the market probably is favoring this proposition that quality stocks with good fundamentals and lower book values, probably price to book rather, I think is basically suggesting the buy opportunity. So maybe SBI as one, I think we feel that I think could be an opportunity to buy, particularly if any correction of a degree of so, I think one should buy into the SBI kind of a stock.
Okay, you know what? You're the second person in the last 1 hour to say that the worst is over for PSU banks and you should buy SBI. Mark Matthews was the other one. Apart from that, I also wanted your thoughts on the steel sector, because yesterday JSW Steel came out with a good set of numbers. We should get that stock up for you. Higher steel prices, the EBITDA actually almost doubled year on year for JSW Steel. It's been flat post its earnings, Deven, but in general, how are you positioned here and is this a stock for long-term investors?
Again, Sonia, I wouldn't know about JSW, but steel sector in common, I think we feel that the times are good, particularly for this commodity. On one side, international market prices are remaining stable, they are remaining good. China has moved to electric arc furnaces, so obviously I think the pricing factor on the commodity side has also started improving for them. And as a result of which, I think the realization, and as you rightly said, I think in case of JSW, the EBITDA, the realizations have started probably have improving and it will improve further. That's what my take would be. I would think that on one side you have got the volume to support, particularly for India steel companies where the domestic market is giving maximum amount of opportunity due to the infrastructure spending happening in the country. So on one side volume-led growth and on the other side the margins, both of them are combining together at least in this cycle for steel companies. So according to me, I think the times could be better going forward. We'll have to be selective in picking companies at least with 2 years horizon to stay invested.
Yeah, we did have a discussion trying to check out if metal prices itself will peak off. Well, people were not very bearish, but not very bullish either, that there are further upsides. That's not what we got from the metal experts we spoke with. But of course, corporates are another story. On that note, let's invite Ashwini back into the conversation. Ashwini, steel itself peaking off, you think, stock-wise?
See, stocks peak off in anticipation of the cycle peaking off. So the best results in commodities generally coincide with the peaking of the cycle. The way, you know, large stocks like Vedanta, Tata Steel, Hindalco, everything has fallen. That shows that maybe a peaking off of the cycle may be coming. So any sort of rally you get on these good results should be used to sell into metal stocks.
And your call on the public sector banks, any of them suggesting long positions?
See, again, you know, these are trading rallies and the rally didn't start yesterday. They have been on for a bit. But clearly, 200-day moving averages of all these stocks are higher than the current price, maybe by 5 to 8%. So those are the sort of rallies you should be looking at. But again, PSU banks cannot take the Bank Nifty above previous highs. So that way, there is a leadership issue that retail banks are kind of taking a back seat. And these PSU banks are looking at short covering.
Okay, well, KPIT technology is under pressure in pre-opening. It's down after its numbers. The revenue growth was hardly anything. It was much lower than estimated, just a growth of 0.2%. So SBI is really the big mover. And Ashwini, as you said, PSU banks may not take the market higher. But what would the call be on SBI now, Sudarshan?
SBI is an investment buy. It's the best of the lot between, say, among the PSU banks, although it's not exactly PSU. It's the best. It's something you need to keep in your portfolio now.
You could see that of some of their bankers as well, actually. Mitesh, anything on your radar now?
See, SBI was on my buy list, and I think a lot of PSU banks might open with a gap up, and I think there's some kind of trading momentum for the next few days should be there. Also, I'll keep a very close watch on ITC, which is very at the verge of breaking above very important levels of 287, 288, and it's got numbers today as well. So I think anything past 290, I think, would definitely interest me in ITC.
Well, actually, Canada Bank numbers are indicating that the healing process is on, and therefore the already stronger ones like SBI and maybe BOB will perk up. Well, Ashwini, I think we didn't discuss your big 9-10 call.
See, first of all, Nifty is not even 1 point higher. So this is a very narrow opening. So unlikely there is a big opportunity at the open on the indices. But I think Tata Elxsi, in spite of maybe opening lower, could see buying at lower levels. So that's a buy with a stop of 1440, target of 1510.
Okay. The crude-related companies are starting lower. There was a minor perk up in crude prices because of lower inventories in the global market. So BPCL, IOC, HP are starting lower. Devin, a more blanket question for you, or a blank check question. In the results season, what has impressed you? What have you all added at KR Choksi into your buy list?
So, Lata, I think we have continued to like, I think, the companies which we have been following. One among them, I think, which came out with a stellar set of numbers, I think, was Starlight Technologies. I think we like the company, we like the numbers. The second most impressive one, I think, was the Bajaj Twins, and particularly Bajaj FinServ, where we see the larger amount of potential also for the insurance business now going forward. So I think the finance, of course, has been on full stream. I think it's fully powered, I think, as far as the growth is concerned. The insurance is now probably going to be the next growth driver for the Bajaj Group. So Bajaj FinServ looks interesting. Bajaj Finance looks interesting. And with this correction in the stock price for Bajaj Auto, I think we are more convinced, because as such, on the larger volume, they would be producing more profit, though there may be some amount of profit margin compromise. But I think they have a balance sheet to play with. So that's where my confidence level lies. And I think they have an export to support them. So these issues, and as a result of which, I think few of these companies, they really give us, I think, a good amount of opportunity. And particularly Starlight Technologies, where we see the growth possibly could be manifold going forward in next 3 years.
What about Reliance ahead of its numbers tomorrow, Devin? How are you positioned? I mean, the refining segment is expected to be weak, but stripped of that, most of the other segments expected to do well. You think a lot of it is already in the price?
Well, from quarterly perspective, Sonia, if you see, I think you may see the stock price, I think, adequately reflecting into the numbers that are likely to come good tomorrow. So from that point of view, I think I would not have any reason to put across. But the fact remains that on one side, you have the entire consumer-facing business, and on the other side, industrial businesses. Industrial businesses, with the feedstock changing in refining segment, probably would start showing better profit margins. Of course, polymers and petrochemicals are showing the volume-led growth as well. So that continues. That part of the story continues. More interesting would be the geo factor, because I think they have been producing large amount of subscribers. They have been producing better numbers on the revenue side. And going forward, the visibility becomes more and more clear with the fiber to home strategy becoming clearer. So whether I think for the quarterly purpose the stock is fully priced, I don't know. But if you are holding the company for investment for the long term, as I am recommending, probably I think I see a good clarity for next 2 years. In fact, fiber to home could be a game changer. It could produce probably I think significant amount of profit for the company, and could possibly help the company to recover the investment faster. At the same time, could produce the profit more than the core business in which Reliance is currently. So I think we remain distinctly confident about Reliance, whether we look at the quarterly numbers or beyond. I think we remain confident about the company.
Okay. Well, Devin, that's a photo finish because the markets are just about to open and it looks like as flat can be.